Praise the name of the Lord. A pleasant good evening to all our viewers around the world. A pleasant good night to all our Facebook friends, all watch parties that have been hosted tonight, and even a special good night to all the members, my God, of the New Creation Ministries of Trinidad and Tobago. Praise the name of the Lord. We are the New Creation Ministries. I am Reverend Michelle Centrose, and this is Bishop Kyle Centrose. And we want to welcome you to a very special service this evening. That is the Feast of Pentecost service. Praise the name of the Lord. This evening, my God, we would like to start off, praise the name of the Lord, with the blowing of the shofars this evening. Praise the name of the Lord. And I will hand over to our bishop.
Praise the Lord. And we know the significance of the shofar.
Amen.
Praise the name of the Lord. And Pastor Michelle, you would like to let the world know what the shofar signifies?
Praise the name of the Lord. You know, the shofar, more or less, it represents the voice of God this evening. Praise the name of the Lord. And even as the shofar is being sounded this evening, you know, it is a symbol, my God, and figuratively used for tearing down walls, my God, spiritual warfare this evening. Things that are out of divine alignment where the word of God is concerned in your life, whatsoever sphere we are talking about, it brings things back into divine order this evening, according to the will and purpose of God this evening. Amen. Praise the name of the Lord. So we would like to sound the shofar even as we open in a word of prayer this evening, and then we're going to usher straight into our worship. Praise the name of the Lord. It's the Feast of Pentecost this evening. Praise the name of the Lord. And we are celebrating, my God, the gift of the Holy Ghost this evening. Praise the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Father, we bless your name tonight. Father, we glorify your name. Who is like unto our God this evening? There is none like unto him this evening. We worship you, O Lamb of God. We acknowledge your Lordship, O God, in our lives, in our homes. Father, in everything concerning us this evening, we humble ourselves, O God, under your mighty hands of grace. Father, we are thanking you for this season, oh God, this season of Pentecost, mighty Father, where we are remembered this evening, oh Father, the gift of your Holy Ghost this evening. Father, this evening, in the mighty name of Jesus, we take authority, oh God, over the very atmosphere known in homes tonight. We bind principalities and powers. We bind rulers of darkness and spiritual wickedness in high places. We tear down strongholds this evening in the mighty name of Jesus. And we superimpose the power and the anointing of God in respective homes tonight. Father, we invoke the divine presence of your Holy Ghost tonight as we place angels on assignment, oh God. Lord, we claim the unction to function this evening. We claim fresh oil this evening. We claim, mighty Father, refreshing and a revival among your people this evening, in this moment and in this hour of divine visitation, oh God. Father, we are thanking you, oh Father, for the season this evening. You be glorified, oh God. You be magnified, oh Jesus. We bless your name. We bless your name. We give you glory this evening. We give you honor this evening. We bless you, oh God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. There is none like unto him. We worship him this evening. We bless his holy name. We give you glory. We give you glory. Hallelujah. 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 Take control tonight, hallelujah, oh Jesus. Move by your spirit tonight. For it's not by might, neither it's by power tonight, but it's by your spirit tonight, oh God. Take control tonight. Hallelujah. Holy Ghost, move tonight. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Glory.
Thank you, Jesus.
Glory.
Hallelujah.
Yeah, Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
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 At this morning time, we would like to usher into a worship service, Lord, this evening. Praise the name of
give
the Lord.
The praise.
Our bishop would lead in worship, and we have praise. Our backup singers here.
We give him the praise.
Praise the name of the Lord.
We give him the honor.
Hallelujah.
We give him the glory.
Thank you, Lord.
Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord tonight. Hallelujah. All our brethren and all those that are under the reach of our voice and all those of you who are tuned in, praise the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. In Facebook land, praise the Lord. We just want you to enjoy the presence of the Lord. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
For we know that in the presence of the Lord there is fullness of joy.
Amen.
And in his right hand's pleasure forevermore.
Hallelujah.
God inhabit in the praises of his people.
Thank you, Jesus.
And we just want to worship him.
Hallelujah.
Praise the name of the Lord. It is hallelujah. It is hallelujah. Another date of Pentecost. Hallelujah.
Amen.
It is a time of celebration.
Thank you,
it
Lord.
It is a time of remembering. Praise
yes.
the name of the Lord. What the Lord has done for us.
Amen.
What the Lord is doing for us.
Amen.
And what the Lord will continue to do for us.
Thank
hallelujah.
You, Lord. Thank
praise
you,
the
Lord.
Name of the Lord. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord. Let us just celebrate
Thank
and
you,
give
Jesus.
God the praise. He's worthy of all our praises.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Yes, Lord. Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah.
You're holy.
strength.
Jesus.
Hallelujah.
He is our hiding place tonight. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord.
Father, we praise Him. Thank you, Jesus. Praise the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Father, we give you the praise.
Thank you, Jesus.
We give you the honor.
Thank you, Jesus.
We give you the glory.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Praise Hallelujah. The name of the Lord. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah. I stand amazed. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord. Hallelujah.
Jesus.
Praise the Lord. Thank you, Jesus.
Joy beside hope. one like you.
Hallelujah.
Father, we give you the praise. Yes, Lord.
Victory
Hallelujah.
Belongs to Jesus.
Victory
tonight.
Belongs to him tonight.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Yeah.
glory belongs to Him. Oh, 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 oh.
Bye.
Tonight, yes, Lord. Praise the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Without him tonight, my God, we can't do anything tonight. Praise
my
the name
God.
Of the Lord. Tonight, believers. Tonight,
my
brethren.
God.
Praise the name of
Hallelujah.
The Lord. It's indeed, my God, a special occasion
oh, yes.
tonight.
Hallelujah.
My God, it's one of God's divine
praise
appointment with
it
us
is.
Tonight.
Hallelujah.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Yes, Lord.
And Bishop, when I look back, my God, and I look at the plans of God, I look at the divine plans of God, my God, I stand amazed. I stand amazed at the wisdom of our God tonight. He's a God of plan. He's
Hallelujah.
A God of purpose tonight.
Yeah,
he's a God of objectivity tonight.
Hallelujah.
He don't do anything, my
yeah,
God,
Lord.
Without purpose and intention tonight. My God, as I stand tonight
Hallelujah.
And I reflect, my God, the very works of my God tonight. I stand, my God, and I look back.
Hallelujah.
My God, the plan of redemption of mankind. And I see how much
oh,
he
yeah.
did for us.
Hallelujah.
Because, my God, he wants to draw nigh. My God, with man back together again. Praise the name of the Lord. As I stand tonight and I reflect, my God, my God, on Passover, the Feast of Passover and I look at first fruits and I look at Feast of Unleavened Bread and I look at the Feast of Pentecost. My God, He's a God of purpose. He's a God of plan. He's a God of objectivity. Because when we look at Passover tonight, He came to redeem mankind. My God, from sin tonight, He paid the price upon the cross. My God, through the shedding of blood tonight, He said there would have been no remission of sins. But my God, He smeared His blood. My God, for all those that would receive tonight. My God, He died for the sins of the world. When we look at first fruits, my God, He was the first fruit of them that sleep tonight. My God, as a promise to us tonight, my God, that we are going to be resurrected on that day, on that great and terrible day. We are going to be resurrected tonight. When we look at the Feast of Unleavened Bread, we are reminded tonight that we ought to be living a life that is holy, that is righteous, that is set apart unto the Master's use. We ought to be kings and priests. We ought to be a holy nation, moving forward, my God, and advancing the kingdom of God upon the earth. When I look at the Feast of Pentecost, my God, the promise was given. My God, the promise of the Holy Ghost, where no longer the Holy Ghost just came upon man, my God, for service, but now the Holy Ghost dwells within us. My God, you gotta understand. My God, He came to give us an advantage in this life. My God, where we are able to move beyond the natural strength, our natural abilities tonight, and we are able to press forward. My God, we are able to do that which we were not able to do, my God, in our own strength, but through the power of the Holy Ghost, we are able, through the unction tonight, we are able to function in any capacity of life. It doesn't matter if you have a degree or if you are qualified. What qualifies us tonight, my God, is Jesus Christ. My God, He says He will qualify tonight. My God, and when you have the power, when you have the unction to function, man, no man tonight, my God, can deny that.
My Lord,
no man can dismiss that tonight. But my God, the Holy Ghost came. My God, He came, my God, as a symbol to us tonight. My God, at that moment, at the moment of Pentecost, my God, it was a moment of betrothal as well. You gotta understand that the gift of the Holy Ghost, my God, it is our promise tonight. It is our engagement tonight. My God, that He's coming back. Some people tend to think that Pentecost reflects, my God, the rapture of the church. But no, no, no. My God, Pentecost depicts, my God, empowerment. My God, to be able to function on behalf of the kingdom tonight. Effectively upon the earth. What you gotta understand is they that know their God shall be strong, and they shall do great exploits. What you gotta understand tonight is that He empowers us to do that which we were unable to do in our natural strength tonight. Praise the name of the Lord. But my God, these feasts from Passover, first fruits, unleavened bread, my God, the Feast of Pentecost, my God, it has been fulfilled. My God, what we are looking forward to, we are presently in rehearsals tonight. My God, the next feast, my God, to be fulfilled is the Feast of Trumpets, which is a reflection, my God, of the catching away or the snatching away of the church tonight. My God, if He has fulfilled the rest, my God, will He not fulfill the others? My God, you gotta look forward. It's a time of celebration, people. It's a joyous occasion.
Yeah.
Because my God, the Holy Ghost, we were meant to show him off.
Yeah.
My God, what do you do with an engagement ring?
My God.
My God, you show it off.
Yeah.
My God, an engagement ring speaks that you are taken tonight.
Yeah.
My God, and this is why it's important
for
you to be baptized, my God. My God, under the anointing and the power and the fire of the Holy Ghost tonight. Praise the name of the Lord, because it's the Holy Ghost that will resurrect you on the day of the rapture. Praise the name of the Lord and nothing else. It's the Spirit of God tonight. You gotta understand, my God, the purpose of God.
Yeah.
You gotta understand the plans of God.
Yeah.
My God, he does nothing without purpose. Everything that he does is with purpose tonight. My God, and we are presently, my God, in rehearsals tonight.
My Lord, yes.
My God, this is not a gimmick thing.
No.
He said that these feasts ought to be recognized perpetually tonight.
My God, amen.
Because
amen.
We are in rehearsals. Praise the name of the Lord. My God, you gotta understand that when these feasts come around, my God, is God looking into mankind affairs. He wants to awaken you when the shofar is sounded.
My God,
if you are in slumber tonight, it is to awaken you out of slumber tonight. It is an alarm tonight to remind you, praise the name of the Lord, of who you are, my God, and what you are called
my
to
Lord,
tonight, and to shake yourself if you are out of alignment, back into divine alignment of God. Praise the name of the Lord. My God, when he comes, my God, and these divine appointments that he has, he don't come empty-handed tonight.
No.
Praise the name of the Lord. He comes to equip tonight. He comes, my God, to reinforce. He comes, my God, to elevate and to promote tonight.
Yeah.
We serve a God, my God, that loves to elevate.
Amen.
He loves to prosper
Amen.
Tonight. He loves to look into the fruits of his
Amen.
Planting tonight. He loves, my God, to see us prosper tonight.
God.
Believers, we are in. My
Hallelujah.
God, a powerful season. My God, and even as we reflect and we look tonight, my God, on the very first Pentecost, when the laws was given upon Mount Sinai, the Bible says that 3,000 died. But my God, under the new covenant, when the Holy Ghost came in like a mighty rushing wind, the mercies of God and the grace of God was extended.
My God,
that all nations were able to hear the good news of salvation. And 3,000 men were added into the kingdom of God. My God, because of the redemption price of God tonight. Hallelujah. We gotta understand what we are called unto tonight.
My God.
Hallelujah.
Yes, Lord.
The Holy Ghost came
to
give us that advantage.
Oh, yeah.
My God, he came to bear witness, not of yourself tonight, but he came to bear witness of Jesus Christ tonight. My God, our message is not our own tonight, but it is his message tonight. He loves you tonight.
Yes, Lord.
My
yes,
God,
Lord. Yes, Lord.
Praise the name of
yes,
Jesus.
Lord.
And for this tonight, my God, we thank him.
Thank you.
We thank him tonight.
Father, we give him the
Hallelujah.
Praise. We give him the
honor. Kingdom of God is not of words tonight,
my God,
but it's of power,
it's of power.
Tonight. It is
power.
Of demonstrative power
yes,
tonight.
Lord.
So sons of God, believers tonight. It is about time that we rise to the occasion.
Yes, Lord.
Understand what we are into tonight.
My God.
Understand what we have been empowered to do tonight.
My God.
Praise the name of the Lord.
My
we
God.
Have been empowered tonight to
My God.
Spread the good news.
Oh, hallelujah.
My God, of salvation.
Hallelujah.
This is what the Holy Spirit, my God,
my God,
indwells in us. That is his purpose within us
My
tonight.
God.
My God, the prophets said no longer. My God, the prophets decreed and declared. They said no longer. My God, will the word of Lord be written upon the stone, the tablets, my God. But he said, I give to you a new covenant in those days.
Amen.
He said, the laws of God will be written upon our hearts tonight
Amen.
And upon our minds tonight.
Amen.
Praise
Amen.
The name of
Amen.
The Lord. The more that you know the word of God tonight,
Amen.
It is the more the Holy Ghost is able, my God, to witness, my God, Jesus unto others tonight.
Yes, Lord.
Praise the name of the
Hallelujah.
Lord. So we thank him tonight.
Yes, Lord.
We thank you, Jesus, for sending the Comforter tonight.
Yes, Lord.
We thank you tonight, oh God.
Yes, Lord.
Be glorified tonight.
Glorified.
Be magnified tonight, Bishop. Praise the name,
praise
of, the
name of the Lord. Hallelujah.
I want to hand over,
oh,
my God, to our Bishop
Lord.
Tonight. Praise
oh,
the name
praise
of the Lord.
Lord.
Believe
Hallelujah.
Us. My God, it's
oh,
a festive
yes, Lord,
occasion.
Yes, Lord, yes, Lord.
When we look back, my God, and we study the Feast of Pentecost.
My God,
the Bible says, my God, that they brought in their gifts, their offerings unto God, my God,
amen,
with a
amen.
Merry heart tonight.
Yes, amen.
Because they wanted to thank God.
Yes.
My God, they wanted to bless him, my
yes.
God, for that which he has done for them.
Praise
my
the
God,
Lord.
And that which when you saw that first fruit tonight, the rest, my God, the rest of that which he has entrusted unto you, it is naturally sanctified
God,
and blessed
God,
tonight.
God,
amen.
The
praise the name
Hallelujah.
Of the Lord. So, my
Father,
God, in these Christ. Special occasions,
yes,
we don't ever appear before God empty handed.
No.
But, my God, in an act of faith,
amen.
We give that thanksgiving offering
amen,
tonight.
Amen,
praise
amen,
the name
amen,
of
amen.
The Lord. So, believers, I'm excited tonight.
Praise the Lord.
I'm excited for what the Lord is doing, my
praise
God,
the
throughout the world among our brethren tonight,
oh,
because,
yes.
my God,
Hallelujah.
We are about to go a little higher. Amen.
Oh,
so my God, tonight we want to hear
Hallelujah.
What directions the Lord is taking us to.
Praise,
praise
the
name of the Lord. And to carry us to the throne room of grace, my God, breaking the bread of life,
praise
is
the Lord.
Bishop Reverend Carl
Oh,
Sandros.
Praise the Lord. Thank you so much, woman of God. Praise the name of the Lord, my God. The woman of God set or laid the foundation. Praise the name of the Lord. And my God, if I don't, my God, take this opportunity to just continue to build on that foundation. Praise the name of the Lord. I'm going to miss the mark. Praise the name of the Lord. Because the woman of God, the hallelujah, through the Spirit of God, she laid the foundation. Hallelujah. Praise the name of the Lord for us to build upon this Pentecost evening. Praise the name of the Lord. A time, hallelujah, when we recognize, hallelujah, what our God has done for us by empowering us. Praise the name of the Lord. And she said that this is a time, my God, that we recognize and remember empowerment. Praise the name of the Lord. It is a time of inauguration. Praise the name of the Lord. Not, my God, the starting of the church, but the church being, my God, endowed with power from on high. Praise the name of the Lord. Yes. Hallelujah. The woman of God said a while ago, hallelujah, my God, that 3,000 die at, my God, the first Pentecost. But my God, at pray, my God, that is the first Pentecost. Hallelujah, my God, at the in the Old Testament. But my God, in the New Testament, hallelujah, the first Pentecost in the New Testament, praise the name of the Lord, 3,000 was added to the church. And my God, I said to you before, praise the name of the Lord, that if 3,000 was added to the church, it means that the church existed, hallelujah, because the church is built upon the foundation of the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. And praise the name of the Lord tonight, hallelujah, we have much to give God praise for. And hallelujah, we have so much to give God praise for this Pentecostal night. But I want you to note something tonight, hallelujah, and I know that you have your Bibles tonight. You see, that spirit baptism that took place on the day of Pentecost, that spirit baptism that took place, it could not, hallelujah, be given until the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ would have been glorified. Hallelujah. So somebody, hallelujah, something had to happen before that spirit baptism. And as, hallelujah, the woman of God said, that spirit baptism on the day of Pentecost, it would have been to empower you. It would have been to empower you, because it's Jesus, hallelujah, in Acts chapter 1 verses 48, Jesus said that in Acts chapter 1 verses 48, hallelujah, the Bible reads here, and being assembled together with them, he commanded them, that they should not depart from Jerusalem, but wait for the promise of the Father. Jesus commanded them, don't depart from Jerusalem. Wait for the promise of the Father, which said here, you have heard of me. For John baptized, he said, for John truly baptized with water. He said that you shall be baptized with the Holy Ghost not many days hence. You shall be baptized with the Holy Spirit. Jesus, hallelujah, he was speaking about the day of Pentecost. He said, you shall be baptized, hallelujah. He said, John baptized you in water. He said, but you shall be baptized with the Holy Ghost not many days hence. In verses 60, he said, when the Bible read, when the therefore will come together, they asked of him, saying, Lord, will thou at this time restore the kingdom to Israel? And he said unto them, it is not for you to know the times or the seasons which the Father hath put in his own power. It is not for you to know the times or the season which the Father has put in his own power. He said, but you shall receive power. He said, but you on that day, he said, you shall receive power after that the Holy Ghost is come upon you. You'll receive power after the Holy Ghost come upon you, and you shall be witnesses unto me, both in Jerusalem and in Judea and in Samaria and unto the uttermost part of the earth. You shall be witnesses for me. You shall be my ambassadors. You shall be my representatives. What Jesus was saying to the disciples or to his followers, it is when this power come upon you, you'll become like me. You'll begin, hallelujah, to show forth, my God, the glory that I had and that you had with the Father from the beginning. You'll begin, hallelujah, to experience, my God, that anointing that your Father had given to you from the beginning, when he told you that you will have dominion. You will have, my God, your first estate that you lose as a result of sin, because of one man's sin. Sin have passed upon all generation. He was saying when that power is come upon you, he was saying that, my God, that glory that you had with the Father from the beginning, you will receive that glory once more again. Hallelujah. Oh yes, he was saying, hallelujah, that power will give you that anointing to go back to your original state. You see, somebody, I want you to understand, this was the purpose, as we discussed on last week on Sunday. This was the purpose for the coming of the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. He came, hallelujah, my God, he came to pass judgment, hallelujah, upon the enemy that stole from us. My God, we know the Bible teaches that the devil came to steal, he came to kill, and he came to destroy. But Jesus came, hallelujah, in the fullness of time, he came to pass judgment upon the enemy. For as we read in St. John Gospel, chapter 12 and verses 32:1-32, we read there that Jesus, hallelujah, speaking, he said, now is the judgment of this world. Now, he was speaking about, my God, the time that Jesus was about to go to the cross. He said, now is the judgment of this world. He said, now shall the prince of this world be casted out. Now, judgment is about to pass.
cast upon the prince of this world.
Yeah.
And I told him,
yeah,
when you look at that word judgment,
yeah,
that word judgment there,
yeah,
it speaks, hallelujah,
yeah,
about a judicial proceeding.
Yeah.
It speaks, hallelujah,
yeah,
my God,
yeah,
about a turning point.
Yeah.
It speaks, hallelujah,
yeah,
about a judicial proceeding,
yeah,
where a judge,
yeah,
is about to pass judgment.
Yeah.
Hallelujah,
yeah,
my God,
yeah,
upon someone who's been accused.
Yeah.
And somebody, hallelujah,
yeah,
it speaks about condemnation.
Yeah.
It speaks, my God,
yeah,
hallelujah,
yeah,
about damnation.
Yeah.
I want you to understand,
yeah,
hallelujah,
yeah,
as we heard the woman of God tonight,
yeah,
she said Jesus came,
yeah,
so that you, hallelujah,
yeah,
will be,
yeah,
able,
yeah,
to experience,
yeah,
and to demonstrate,
yeah,
all that Jesus have,
yeah,
and all that Jesus is.
Yeah.
Pentecost marks that moment,
yeah,
hallelujah,
yeah,
when judge, I want you to understand,
yeah,
but judgment had to be passed,
yeah,
upon the enemy first.
Yeah.
The Bible, Jesus said, yeah, that my God today,
yeah,
the prince of this world,
yeah,
will be casted out.
Yeah.
Hallelujah,
yeah.
The prince of this world,
yeah,
will be casted out today. Hallelujah. Judgment is about to be passed upon the prince of this world. Hallelujah. And we saw that the prince of this world, my God, was Satan. The prince of this world is still Satan. For all that are in this world is the lust of the eyes, the lust of the flesh, and the pride of life. But somebody, hallelujah, Jesus, hallelujah, hallelujah, that judicial proceeding have already take place, and the devil is already condemned. The devil, hallelujah, he's already condemned. Hallelujah, my God, we don't need to worry about what the devil can do, hallelujah, or what the devil will do, because he's already condemned. He came to steal, to kill, and to destroy. But the Bible said that judgment that Jesus came to pass upon him is to give us life, and to give it to us more abundantly. Hallelujah. The life that you lose as a result of sin, Jesus came and he gave that life back unto you. It is because of his exaltation, because he said, hallelujah, in verses 31, hallelujah, of John chapter 12, he said, now is the judge. My God, verses 32, he said, hallelujah, he's in verses 30, he said, and I, if I be lifted up, he said, if I be lifted up, I will draw all men unto me. And somebody, praise the name of the Lord, I will draw all men unto me. Jesus was saying here, not my God, if he be lifted up from the ground unto the cross, but Jesus was saying there, it is if I am exalted, if I be exalted, hallelujah, I will then draw men unto me. And what does this mean? Hallelujah. That Jesus will draw men unto him. I want you to understand, because Jesus is being lifted up, because he humbled himself to the death of the cross, and he's now lifted up at the right hand of the Father in heaven. The Bible teaches that we are now made to be seated in heavenly places with Christ Jesus. Somebody, hallelujah, you got to know that because of that judgment that was pass on the enemy, you are now, hallelujah, in heavenly places with Christ Jesus. Hallelujah. You'll be lifted up to another level. When Jesus said, if I be exalted, meaning after I go on the cross and I go to the grave, and hallelujah, and I go down, hallelujah, my God, into hell, and I come back out from hell, and after, hallelujah, I'm being glorified, he said, I am going to lift men to another level. I'm going to lift them to another standard. Men will no longer, hallelujah, men who know me will no longer lose their first estate. Men who know me will no longer be men who fell from the glory of God, because I'm going to lift them right back up to that place of dominion. I'm going to put them in that place of authority. I'm going to put them in that place after God is man. Hallelujah. Oh, Yatarababasayandanodia. He said, I am going to lift him up. It is because of Jesus' exaltation that he came, that he can draw all men to him. All men to him by the Holy Spirit and miraculous work to the believers in confirming the gospel. Hallelujah. The Holy Ghost came. Hallelujah. So that the miracle working of God, the powers of God can be made known to you, can be confirmed to you. Hallelujah. My God, to you, the believers, in confirming the gospel. You see, somebody, I said confirming the gospel. Jesus, hallelujah, did not send the second person of the Godhead by chance, but he came so that, my God, you will receive power to confirm. Hallelujah. The gospel. Hallelujah. What do I mean by confirming the gospel? You know, in St. John Gospel, chapter 7, verses 37 to 39. St. John Gospel, chapter 7, verses 37 to 39. The Bible reads there, hallelujah, in the last day, that great day of the feast. In the last day, that great day of the feast. Hallelujah. It was very close to the crucifixion of the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. The Bible said Jesus, he stood up. He stood up and he cried out saying, we are looking, hallelujah, at St. John Gospel, chapter 7, verses 37 to 39. The Bible said he cried out saying, he said, if any man thirst, let him come unto me and drink. If any man thirst, let him come unto me and drink. He said, he that believeth on me, as the scripture had said, out of his belly shall flow rivers of living water. So somebody, hallelujah, he was talking about that anointing, that power that will come on the day of Pentecost. He said, my God, he that believe in me, that time is coming when out of his belly is going to flow rivers of living water. Hallelujah. Verses 39, the Bible reads, but this speak he of the Spirit, which they that believe on him should receive. For the Holy Ghost was not yet given, because that Jesus was not yet glorified. So I told him that Jesus had to be glorified before the second person of the Godhead come, before the Holy Spirit come, because I want you to understand, he will come in, hallelujah, to fill man's belly with rivers of living water. He will come in, my God, to make you not an ordinary person, but somebody, hallelujah, we are not ordinary. We are the sons of the living God. He will come in, my God, to make you representatives and ambassadors for God, so that when men see you, they will see the God man in you. They will see God in you. For greater is him that lives in me than him that lives in the world. I can do all things through the Christ who lives in me. Robo Satabaya. That is what the Holy Ghost is about in St. John 7. St. chapter 7. Hallelujah. My God, sir. St. John chapter 14 and verses 12. St. John 14 and verses 12, Jesus said, "Verily, verily, I say unto you, he that believeth on me, the works that I do, shall he do also. He that believeth in me, the works that I do, shall he do also. Oh, yakarababa, and greater," I love that, "and greater works than these shall he do, because I go unto the Father." Jesus was telling them, when I go to the Father, I have to go to the Father so that a second person in the Godhead can come. If I am here, my God, he cannot come. I have to go, and I'm going to send him to you. But my God, hallelujah, Jesus was saying, when he comes, hallelujah, he said, when I go to the Father and he come, he said, the works that I do, you shall do greater. You shall do greater, hallelujah, greater works than I have done. I want you to understand, hallelujah, God has been saying to the church that it's his time to show up and show off in you. It is his time to make himself known in you. Hallelujah. God wants you, hallelujah, to know. Hallelujah. Oh, your Korababasaya Nodia. Rum Ekanda, who you are in him. He wants you to know who you are in him. Hallelujah. Father, we give you the praise. Oh, yes. In Acts, in the book of Acts, chapter 2 and verses 33. The book of Acts chapter 2 and verses 33. Hallelujah. The Bible reads here. Therefore being by the right hand of God. Be therefore being by the right hand of God exalted, and having received of the Father the promise of the Holy Ghost, the promise of the Holy Ghost, he hath shed forth this, which he now see and hear. Hallelujah. I want you to understand, he had to go to the Father, but somebody, hallelujah, a judgment had to take place on the cross, and that judgment, hallelujah, took place, and the devil is a condemned man now. We give the devil too much ranks. We give him too much ranks in our lives, failing to realize or to know who we are in God. I want you to understand, the devil is a condemned man. He's only listening to this man. He's only waiting for the day of, my God, he's only waiting for the day of sentencing. I want you to understand, it is only a matter of time. He'll be sentenced, my God, to eternal death. I want you to understand right now, my God, the devil is wrong and walking in death. He, my God, is death itself. But somebody, hallelujah, I want you to know, hallelujah, that Jesus has taken away the key of death and the grave. And somebody, hallelujah, I give God praise and thanks today, because, hallelujah, what Jesus has done for us, what Jesus has done for us, I want you to know, hallelujah, my God, no devil from hell can prevail against us. Hallelujah. Father, we give you the praise. Thank you, Lord, for Pentecost. You know who it is. In the Mark chapter 16, verses 17 to 20. The Bible reads there in Mark chapter 16, and I want you to understand, I said to you that we all, hallelujah, the Holy Ghost came so that we will confirm, my God, you know, Pastor Michelle, the woman of God said earlier, hallelujah, that my God, that my God, hallelujah, that the kingdom of God is not just of words, but it is of power. And somebody, I want you to know, when Jesus came, he said, thy kingdom come. He said, my God, the kingdom of the Father, the kingdom of God, hallelujah, is here. And my God, he taught his followers to pray. When you pray, say, thy kingdom come, thy will be done as it is in heaven. Hallelujah, thy will be be done on the earth. I want you to understand, hallelujah, the Holy Ghost came so the will of my God, the rules of heaven can be done on the earth. My God, hallelujah, the will of heaven, my God, must be done on the earth. And somebody praise the name of the Lord. You know, Jesus, hallelujah, and Mark chapter 16, verses 17 to 20, the Bible reads here, and these signs shall follow them that believe. Jesus is speaking here. He said, and these signs shall follow them that believe. My God, Mark chapter 16, verses 17 to 20, and these signs shall follow them that believe. In my name shall they cast off devils. They shall speak with new tongues. They shall take up serpents. And if they drink any deadly thing, it shall not hurt them. If they drink any deadly thing, it shall not hurt them. Hallelujah. They shall lay hands on the sick and they shall recover. Hallelujah. Then, hallelujah. So then, after the Lord had spoken unto them, he was received up unto heaven and sat on the right hand of God. And they went forth. And I want you to look at verses 20. The Bible said, and they went forth and they preached everywhere, the Lord working with them and confirming the words with signs of following. And confirming the word with sign falling. Confirming the word. My God, you don't, come on somebody, you don't have to run after signs. You don't have to run after miracles. My God, hallelujah. Run after the word of God. And my God, and miracles will run and follow you. I want you to understand, the Bible said, hallelujah, my God, God was confirming the word with signs following. Signs were falling, hallelujah. Somebody, I want you to understand that God, hallelujah, is doing a great thing in this time. You have not seen, my God, the fullness of the manifestation of God in this time. While the Spirit of God have been ringing in my spirit, it is that where iniquity abounds, the grace of God and much more abound. You know, also in Luke chapter 24 and verses 49, Jesus said, and behold, I send the promise of my Father upon you. But tarry ye in the city of Jerusalem until you be endued with power from on high. Tarry until you be endued with power. That power that is going to change your life. My God, it's going to make, my God, cause a turning point in your life. Where, my God, that anointing, that power is going to bring you back to the original place where God wants you to be. I want you to understand, I'm talking about a place of dominion. I'm talking about a place of authority. Hallelujah. The place that God wants us to be. In closing tonight, praise the Lord. In closing tonight, I want you to turn your Bible with me to Hebrews chapter 2, verses 3 to 4. Hebrews chapter 2, verses 3 to 4. Verses 3 and 4, or verses 3 to 4. Praise the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. And I'm reading from the book of Hebrews. How shall we escape? Come on. How shall we escape? Come on, I want you to look in your Bibles. Hebrews chapter 2, verses 3 and 4. How shall we escape? And listen to me, somebody. Paul is talking to believers here. He was talking to the church. And he's saying to them, how shall we escape if we neglect so great salvation, which at the first began to be spoken by the Lord and was confirmed unto us by them that heard him? How can we escape If you neglect, my God, you know, my God, you know that word neglect. That word neglect, hallelujah. That word neglect there, hallelujah. Oh my God, when you look at the Greek word, neglect there, it speaks about being negligent. It speaks about being negligent. If you look at the Greek word there, hallelujah, praise the name of the Lord, my God. It also speaks about, hallelujah, to make light. It means, my God, to become negligent about something. I want you to understand, listen to me, somebody. You know, it's important that I clear that up a bit. Let me just clear that up a bit. Praise the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. If you neglect such great a salvation, and I want to give you a deeper insight of what Paul was talking about here. My God, when he said here, hallelujah, how shall we escape if we neglect so great a salvation? And my God, hallelujah, I want to take you to look at 1 Timothy chapter 4 and verses 14. 1 Timothy chapter 4 and verses 14. Praise the name of the Lord. I want to clear up there what Paul is saying. Hallelujah. Praise the name of the Lord. That is 1 Timothy chapter 4 and verses 14. Paul, my God, in 1 Timothy chapter 4 and verses 14, Paul is saying it. He said, and he's talking to Timothy. So we want to understand what Paul meant when he told the church, my God, how can you escape if you neglect such great salvation that was spoken by Jesus and it was confirmed, my God, by others. I want you to understand, my God. Look at 1 Timothy again, chapter 4 and verses 14. Praise the Lord. We are reading that verse here. Hallelujah. The Bible reading, Paul is saying here to Timothy, neglect not the gift. Neglect, my God. It's the same, my God, being negligent about it. It's the same, my God, making it light. Not understanding the power that lives in you. Not understanding the depths of your calling. Not learning to make your calling an election. Not making your calling an election sure. You gotta, my God, make your calling an election sure. And somebody, Paul is saying to Timothy here, he said, neglect not the gifts that is in thee. Neglect, my God, the same thing, yeah, hallelujah, Paul meant here when he said, how can you escape if you neglect so great a salvation? He said to Timothy, he said, neglect not the gift that is in thee. That neglect there is, my God, for is the same Greek meaning. Neglect not the gift that is in thee, which was given thee by prophecy. Which was given thee by prophecy with the laying of on of hands of the presbytery. But I want you to understand, listen to me, somebody, what Paul was saying to Timothy. Timothy, there are certain words that have gone out for your life. There are seven words that has gone out for your life. And my God, yes, you know, hallelujah, the purpose of God for your life. You know the anointing of God that is upon your life. He was saying, look, Timothy, don't neglect this. Don't neglect that gift that is in thee, hallelujah, which was given to you through prophecy, hallelujah. I want you to understand, God don't want us to neglect that gift that is in us. He don't, oh my God, God don't want you to misunderstand. Come on, somebody, the gift that is in you. They that know their God shall be strong, and they shall do great exploit. Hallelujah. They that know him shall be strong, and they shall do great exploit. Let us look at verses 4 of Hebrews chapter 2, verses, we read verses 3. Let us look at verses 4 also. Hallelujah. The Bible, Paul is saying it, God also bearing them witness, both with signs and wonders, and with divers miracles, and gifts of the Holy Ghost, according to his own will. So you understand what Paul was, my God, was referring to when he said, don't neglect it.
Come on.
Go, my God, don't neglect the power that lives in you.
Come on.
Don't neglect, my God, the reason, or don't slight the reason for Jesus coming and dying on the cross.
Yes.
The Bible said he made himself poor so that you can become rich. I want you to understand, you ought to know, my God, that he was wounded for your transgressions. He was bruised for your iniquity. The chastisement of your peace was upon him, and by his stripes you were healed. Hallelujah. Oh my God, you gotta know that, my God, as much as receive him, to them he gave the power. He gave power, my God, to become the sons of God, to be ambassadors, to be representative for God. Hallelujah. You are God's representative. Know who you are in him. Pentecost, hallelujah, was that inauguration.
Amen.
Oh yes, of those who are called the church of God. And I want you to understand, Jesus said, the gates of hell shall not prevail against my church. I want you to understand that God wants you to know who you are in him. God wants you to know, hallelujah, who you are in him. Know that after God is man. I said to you, praise the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. The only difference between God and man, it is that man is limited and God is unlimited.
Amen.
I want you to understand, listen to me, somebody. Hallelujah. God, hallelujah, he created you. Yes, from the dust of the earth. But I want you to know he breathed his divinity into you.
Amen.
He breathed his breath into you. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
So that you will be both earthy and heavenly. So that you will be both earthy and heavenly. This is the reason why the Bible said you are made to be seated not just on the earth, but in heavenly places with Christ Jesus. Because God had designed you, come on somebody, to have dominion, my God, over the sea and over everything that creepeth upon the earth and over everything that exists on the earth and, my God, over everything that even in the heavens. Not, my God, not where the kingdom of God is, but, my God, we have dominion over the heavens also. Hallelujah. So somebody, hallelujah, God, he created you in his own image and in his own likeness. So somebody, God is not earthy. God is heavenly. I want you to understand, hallelujah, he created you like him. Come on, somebody. I want you to know, you got to know who you are. And my God, hallelujah, this is the reason why the Bible said, let that light that is in you so shine before man, that man may see your good work and give God the glory. You are God, hallelujah. You are God's, hallelujah. My God, you are God's representative. You, hallelujah, you, praise the name of the Lord. My God, you are God's ambassador. You are God's, hallelujah, my God, you are God's ambassadors. It means that all that God had and all that God is, it dwells in you. Come on, somebody. I can do all things to Christ who strengthens me. All things, somebody, not some things. I can do all things. You can do all things. Know who you are in Christ. Know who you are in God. Know who you are. Jesus on the cross, after that judgment is passed upon the prince of the world, Jesus said, it is finished. He said, it is finished. It is completed. It is completed. Man now have the rights to go bold before the throne of God. Through me, man can do all things. Hallelujah. Man now received that first estate that he lost. Man have gone back to that place of glory that he fell from. Hallelujah. Know who you are in Christ. Know who you are in Christ. Father, we give you the praise. We give you the praise. We give you the honor. We give you the glory. We thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. For giving your only begotten Son. We thank you, the Lord, for him going to the cross. We thank you, the Lord, for that judicial procedure that took place and judgment was passed upon the enemy that stole from us. Father, we thank you for the victory. Thank you tonight. Thank you. Thank you. Praise the Lord. God bless you tonight. Tonight, as we continue and we getting ready to just do that benediction, and we are talking about our Pentecost benediction, and we want you to note and remember that tonight it marks another date for celebration. Amen. And that other date for celebration, it is Pentecost. And I would have gone to Pentecost. I am not here to go to the teaching on Pentecost, because it's a lot to teach. I would have teach you over the years about Pentecost, so you understand Pentecost from the beginning to where we are now and where it will end. Because Pentecost, I want you to know, the fullness of Pentecost is not fulfilled or fully completed as yet. We'll see Joel talk about some things. And those things that Joel spoke about, I want you to understand that yet some of them are yet to come to pass. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
So somebody, we are still walking and living. Pentecost is alive and well.
Yes.
Holy Ghost is alive and well.
Amen.
And oh my God, hallelujah. Somebody, I'm getting excited. I'm getting excited. Praise the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Father, we give you the praise. Father, we give you the honor. We give you the glory. We bless your holy name. Lord, there is none like unto you.
Thank you, Jesus.
Lord, there is none to take your place.
Hallelujah.
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 Hallelujah. One of the things that you know we do around this time, my family and I, we do it for many years, and God has been good to us. And we know that Pentecost, and as the woman of God reminded you, that Pentecost is around this season is good time to sow seed. And don't, my God, allow COVID-19 to stop you from sowing. For God, he give it seed unto sowers. He only gives seed to sowers. Praise the name of the Lord. And I want you to understand that it is a time, it is a season, praise the name of the Lord, for you to continue to give. Don't stop giving. Don't let COVID-19 or nothing that will happen under the system of this world hold you back from doing that which is necessary in accordance to your salvation. So now it's time to give. And you know where to give. And you know how to give. I've taught you the principles of giving and receiving. So you know, hallelujah, no one have to prompt you or tell you the importance of giving. Praise the name of the Lord, because you are properly well taught. Praise the name of the Lord. I encourage you this season, praise the name of the Lord, give and give wholeheartedly. You know, one of the things that my family always do is we sow special seed around this time. Because we believe, hallelujah, that is a season, hallelujah, of sowing and reaping. We know that we sow and we reap, Oh, my God, we sow on a daily basis because we know that giving a child be given back unto us. See, we know the word. Praise the name of the Lord. Bless the Lord. We know, hallelujah, praise the name of the Lord, all that the Bible speaks about giving. But somebody, I want you to understand, hallelujah, this season, it is a special season for sowing seed. And I want you to know, hallelujah, it is also special visitations, hallelujah, amen, by the presence of the Lord. Amen. I've seen great and powerful things happen, hallelujah, around this season. Amen. I've seen, my God, all different type of miracles over my years of Christianity and over the years of understanding, my God, how powerful these seasons are. I want you to understand, I've seen great things happen. Amen. Even, my God, during this period, hallelujah, I've seen, my God, some great things took place. Amen. And somebody, I want you to understand, hallelujah, that God will always be God. He's the same God yesterday, today, and forevermore. Seasons and times will not change him. My God, COVID season will come and COVID season will go, but God remains the same. Hallelujah. Amen. Praise the Lord. So you know that this is the time of season for giving. Don't hold back on God because of COVID.
Hallelujah.
Know that God wants you to continue to be a giver. Praise the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. We want to do that benediction. And as we do that benediction, hallelujah, I want you to just, hallelujah. Father, we give you the praise. We give you the praise. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Father, we bless your holy name. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Koraba Basaya and Nori.
Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah. 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 Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. I just want you right where you are. Just lift your hands like this and just receive of the Lord tonight. Hallelujah. Just receive of him tonight. He shall give his angels charge concerning us. And in their hands they shall bear us up, lest at any time we dash our feet against a stone. May the Lord comfort us in all our tribulation, that we may be able to comfort them which are in any trouble. By the comfort wherein we ourselves are comforted of God. Hallelujah. May we inherit the blessings of the earth. May his mercy be with us from generation to generation. Let those which be of faith be blessed with faithful Abraham. May the Lord give us the former rain moderately. May he cause to come down for us the rain, the former rain and the latter rain in the first month. May our floors be filled of wheat, and the fat shall overflow with wine and with oil. May restore to us the years that the locusts have eaten, the cankerworm and the caterpillars and the palmerworms, by his great army which he sent among us. Hallelujah. May he eat in plenty and be satisfied and praise the name of the Lord your God that hath dwelt wondrously with you. You shall never be ashamed. You shall always know that the Lord your God is in the midst of you, and that he is the Lord your God and none else. And his people shall never be ashamed. May the Lord bless thee and keep thee. May the Lord make his face to shine upon thee. Koyora Messiah, may the Lord bless thee and keep thee. May the Lord make his face to shine upon thee. May the Lord bless thee and keep thee. May the Lord make his face to shine upon thee and be gracious unto thee. The Lord lift up his countenance upon thee and give you peace in the name of the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. May the Lord lift up his countenance upon thee and give you peace in the name of the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. May the name of Jesus and all its blessings be upon you. May the name of Jesus and all its blessings be upon you. May the name of Jesus and all its blessings be upon you. Hallelujah. May the blood of Jesus cover you. Father, your name be praised. Your name be lifted up. Your name be exalted, O God. In Jesus' name we pray. Hallelujah. 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 Father, your blessings be upon your people. Bless them in their going out.
Yes, Lord.
Bless them in their coming in.
The name of Jesus.
Whatsoever they will put their hands to do.
Father.
Father, we declare prosperity.
In the name of Jesus.
We open every shut door and take back all that which the enemy has stolen.
Yes,
and Father, we return it unto them.
The
we return it 100-fold. Father, your name be glorified.
Yes,
your name be praised.
Yes,
your name be lifted up in death.
Yes,
in Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
And everybody say,
amen.
Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
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 Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord. You know, believers tonight. Happy Pentecost or happy Shavuot to this evening. Praise the name of the Lord. And even as the word of God went out tonight, reminding us to not to neglect, my God, the gift that has been placed within us, my God, through the power of the Holy Spirit. Praise the name of the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
The Lord wants to use you tonight. Praise the name of the
Hallelujah.
Lord. All unto his honor and unto his glory tonight.
Yes,
amen. So, my God, I'm excited, my God, as to this journey, my God, and this continuance of this journey.
Praise the Lord.
My God, in God's kingdom, praise the name of the Lord.
Yes,
to
Lord.
See where he's taken you, to see where he's taken me tonight. Praise the
praise
name
the
of the
Lord.
Lord. And again, from my house to your house, happy Pentecost, happy Shavuot.
Praise
the
Lord.
Name of the Lord.
Praise the Lord. Bless the Lord. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Tonight we give God praise and thanks for
yes.
you again. And enjoy the rest of the day. Praise the name of the Lord. Praise the Lord. Remember, it is rehearsal time.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Enjoy the best of it. Praise the Lord. Let me again, on behalf of me and my families, say happy belated anniversary to our dear brother and sister Lopez.
Praise
the name of the Lord to all the brothers and sisters out there again. I want you to note it's important that you watch out one for the other.
Amen.
No brother or sister among us must ever go hungry.
No.
No brother or sister among us must ever go hungry. I want you to note you ought to be watching out for that brother.
Amen.
Watching out for that sister.
Amen.
And we have a responsibility to make sure that that brother or that sister don't go hungry.
Praise the Lord.
So in this time, I want you to know, yes, one may look at recessions in the world, but there is no recession in the kingdom of God. Amen.
No, no.
God has been good to us.
Amen.
And we will be good to each other. Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Continue to abide by the rules and the laws of your land.
Amen.
Whichever country you might be in, don't get yourself in lawlessness.
Amen.
Stay within the rules.
Thank
praise
you,
the name
Jesus.
Of the Lord. Bless the Lord.
Amen.
And work for you with your governments.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Pray for your governments.
Amen.
Pray for your leaders. Praise the name of the Lord. Wheresoever you might be on the globe, praise the name of the Lord. Remember that God has called you and purposed that you be kings and priests
Amen.
In this place. Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Our high priest already, hallelujah, did done the job.
High priest, yes.
Our great high priest. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
And he wants us to follow. Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord. God
And praise Bishop, this coming Sunday, Pentecost will be rolled over into Sunday. Praise the name of the Lord. So Pentecost Sunday, praise the name of the Lord. Don't miss service. Service starts at 8 a.m., Bishop.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the name of the Lord. Ensure that you tune in. Ensure that you invite somebody, or your family, friends, whosoever it may be. Start watch parties. Praise the name of the Lord. And spread the good news of salvation. Praise the name
Amen.
Of the Lord.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord. Remember again this in closing. The Bible studies that you're receiving, please study, right? Please study, because I want you to note that all the studies that I place there for you, a time is going to come and will have too much on my, I will have too much on my hard drive, and I will have to remove it. So you have it there now. Take as much as you can. Take, study, share with friends. Praise the name of the Lord. Study with friends. Praise the name of the Lord, because the time is coming when I will have to remove it.
Praise
so
the
what
Lord.
And you need to spend some time in studying. If I can put it out there, then you could study it.
Yes.
Because praise the name of the Lord. Bless the Lord. You will Bless observe some
Lord.
Of the times that I'm posting. It's late in the night, sometimes 3 in the morning, 2 in the morning. You know, different time of the night. It's all for you, right? It's all for you. And
praise
we want
the
you
Lord.
To use it. Make sure that you're studying with your Bibles. Amen?
Amen.
Praise the
and
Lord.
And you know, seeing tonight, I saw our dear sister Sherry. Praise the name of the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
You have tuned in tonight. We want to say a special good night to you. Praise the name of the Lord.
Praise.
And your household, I saw that you send greetings, blessings, Pentecostal blessings to you and your household
praise
tonight.
The Lord.
Praise
yes,
the name
praise
of the Lord.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Sister Bula, we thank God. Praise the name of the Lord. You're tuned in.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. We love you. Praise the name of the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Right. Love to you and your family.
Amen.
Praise the name of the Lord. Even this time of Pentecost.
Amen.
Let us continue. Praise the name of the Lord to give God the praise for this season. We love you. Praise the name
Lord.
Of the Lord. And all the folks that are locked on tonight.
Amen.
All the folks that are tuned in. Praise the name of the Lord. Bless the Lord. We love you. And
Amen.
We want you to know, praise the name of the Lord, that you are in our prayer.
Thank
praise the name
Jesus.
Of the Lord. And continue to pray for us.
Amen.
Remember our family in prayer also.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Praise
bless
the Lord.
The Lord. Praise the Lord. God
praise
bless
the Lord.
You.
God bless you.
God bless you.
Have
love
a great
you.
Night.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the name
bless
of the
Lord.
Praise the Lord.